Good morning. Oh my goodness, it's almost 60 degrees outside today. It is 57 and I went to town. I haven't been out of the house since Sunday. Today's Wednesday, since Rose litter was born. And I apologize, I have not uploaded any video of that litter. Someone to disable the ding ding ding. The ding 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 of this seatbelt is an octave that grates on my nerves. So I suppose it's like, I feel like if you want to wear your seatbelt, wear it. If you don't, if you get a ticket, whatever. It's your life. You're yakking on the phone. He's on the phone. Oh, there's a little black dog in back. He's always on the phone, so he's like this great guy. Here, his picture of his truck. We needed to go to Kansas City and haul stuff. My sister moved to Boise, so he let us borrow that fancy truck and his huge stock trailer. And my sister in Kansas City gave us so much furniture for Rachel and fire pit, beautiful outside furniture, chairs, and all this stuff. And he let us borrow his big honking truck and horse, well, it's not a horse trailer, it's a cattle trailer, to go to Kansas City. So they were gone. I think they did come back the same day, but it took us another day to unload the truck. Anyway, it's neighbors like that, right? Precious. Precious neighbors. Dude, he's had a baby and she's got to be 6 months old now. I've only seen him once. Anyway, so today, praise God, all of Rose's puppies are fine and healthy. I am giving a bottle now. As of last night, I gave him a bottle. Gave him a bottle at 3:30 this morning because I just was exhausted and didn't want to sit in there with her for an hour. And she's not getting full anyway. So I wanted to talk about love because Valentine's Day is coming up and I've just got this long to talk. I'm almost to town. Love. Okay, love. Love does. So this guy named Bob something, I forget his last name, he wrote this book called Love Does. You will laugh. You will cry and laugh and cry and cry, and then at the end you'll laugh. And he's so real and he's so funny and he's so full of faith. Anyway, I could cry thinking about the book. He has another one too. Bob. I don't know, he just calls himself Bob. It's like this amazing guy. He says, I'm just Bob. Love Does. And it's talking about, he's got another book out and I think I've got both of them on Audible. If I haven't done both books, I'm going to get the other one because I've got a credit on Audible. He's talking about what is love? Love isn't just a feeling. Love puts feet and makes tracks. Just pulling over and wanting to visit with my neighbor, yet he's on a call. It's probably a business call. I respect that. That's love. You know, in the Passion Translation, Brian Simmons, I love how he says this in 1 Corinthians 13. He says, love does not traffic in disrespect or shame. And so, you know, preaching to myself, if I'm ever being disrespectful to my husband, love does not traffic in disrespect or is funny, an EMS just pulled out of the barbecue place. I'm wondering if someone had a heart attack. Anyway, it's not funny. Love does not traffic. If you're being disrespectful to someone because they've hurt you, and trust me, I've been there. That's not love. We're not walking in the God kind of love. So if you want a picture of love, it's not two people kissing or some passion or some desire. Love is Jesus hanging on the cross when people spit on him. He was innocent, and yet they condemned him as guilty. That's love. When you lay your life down for your friend or your neighbor, that's love. So let's not be confused about what love is. And in 1 Corinthians 13, of course I've memorized it in the King James and the NIV, but read it in the Passion Translation. It's so good. And so this is what God told me after memorizing, you know. It doesn't matter what you memorize. It's what you do. You know, James says, don't be a hearer of the word. Be a doer of the word. Don't just be a hearer only. Be a doer of the word. And so that's why I love that book. Love does. Love gets up off the couch, and it does the dishes. Love does. It does. Jesus said, I did not come to be served, I came to serve. I think that sums up love, right? He didn't come demanding that people serve him. At the Last Supper, he washed his disciples' dirty feet. And Peter said, no, no, Lord, not my feet. And Jesus said, if I don't wash your feet, you have no part in me. And Peter said, not my feet only, wash my head and my hands too. And Jesus said, it is enough that I wash your feet. So what does that look like today? It's not like we need to wash anybody's feet. Our feet aren't dirty, right? We're rich enough to have shoes, not sandals. It looks like cleaning someone's toilet who's sick. That's love. Helping, picking someone up who can't go get groceries. Visiting someone in a retirement home. That's love. Put feet to your words and get out there and do something. So, Valentine's Day, I know, is, promotion, promoted as this passion between a man and a woman. But trust me, after 40 years of marriage, it's not all about passion. Not that passion's not wonderful. Not that passion's not part of it. It is. But it's a small part. A big part is paying attention to your spouse, giving them attention. Oh, so this is what I was going to say. So if you read that, 1 Corinthians 13, just read it for yourself on Bible Gateway. Actually, they took the Passion Translation off of Bible Gateway, so you can find it somewhere else. I have a hard copy. I think this is verse 11. It says, when I was a child, I thought like a child. I spoke like a child, and I understood like a child. But when I became a woman, actually it says man, I put childish ways behind me. And so, in that verse, God is telling me, there are times that we need to grow up. When I was a child, I thought like a child. If someone hit me, I hit them back. But when I became a woman, I put childish ways behind me. And God is calling us to maturity. And I think that is so appropriate that that verse would be right in the middle of the love chapter. Let's see if I can parallel park in here. Because I have two spaces. I think I can do this. This is where my nail appointment is. Right there in that verse about, come on, folks. It's time to grow up. It's not just about our feelings. Of course I feel like hitting people. Are you kidding? Of course. Sometimes I feel like whacking someone. Love does not do that. So may we be full of love, right? So that's my good morning this morning. I am here. May I pray for you. God, fill us with your love. God, if somebody comes up and pokes us, may not bitterness, rage, hate, unforgiveness, or anger come out, but may your love come out because we filled ourselves with your love. In the name of Jesus, I pray that people would feel that love, embrace that love, and read 1 Corinthians 13. Oh Lord, you are amazing, because as that verse says, it doesn't matter if we speak with the tongues of men and angels if we don't have love. It doesn't profit us anything. We're just a sounding brass or a clanging cymbal. We could even give our body to be burned. And without love, it doesn't profit us anything. We could sell everything we have and give it away. But if we didn't do it with the motive of love, it doesn't count in heaven. Love is that important. May we choose to love today. In the name of Jesus.